we doing again?
We're doing an unboxing.
Okay.
We can shoot it out of order or in order, doesn't matter. All right, ready? What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of Bee Fishing, and today we've got a double unboxing. It is the Monster Fast versus MTB Pro unboxing. Stay tuned, you're not gonna wanna miss it. There may even be a giveaway at the end of this, but you gotta stay till the end or the middle. I'm not gonna tell you where we're gonna put it, but it's definitely gonna be at the end, so please don't fast forward. I'll catch you in a second. So each and every month, I end up receiving a mystery tackle box. Chris is now subscribed to Monster Bass Box. This is the national box. It is not the regional box. So $25. That's how we compare. I know a lot of you guys say, oh, get the regional box. It's better because it's, you know, for your region. I understand that, but it's $35. I don't have the mystery tackle box elite box that's $35. So not really a fair comparison.
Apples, apples.
That's what we're trying to do here, apples to apples. See who won the month of January with their mystery tackle box or monster bass box. See who's the better box. All right, I'm gonna bring y'all over this way so y'all can see the unboxing of this. We'll talk quickly about the baits. We'll jump over here to monster bass. We'll talk quickly about those baits. And then we're gonna let you guys get in the comments and decide which one takes the cake as the better box. So here we go. Oh, that's really close, I bet. So we're gonna jump into this box real quick and let's do it. Mystery tackle box for January is this one. So let's get our card out. We've also, where's the dibble? We've always got the dibble, get the dibble out. You know, tips and tricks basically is what the dibble is. We've got our sticker, which is the old football bass. The old, you know, the footballs.
It's like a Clemson bass.
Well, that's very unfortunate. Anyway, so we've got a Reaction Strike, XRM, Castic, Swim Bait Boot Tail, Carl's Amazing Bait, Z-Man, Mollux, Penetration Hooks, as well as an Excites Baits Undershad. So y'all can read. We're not gonna get into this too much, but I'm gonna go in order of this. And we're gonna find that Reaction Strike XRM, which is this guy. It's the XRM 80. I really like that paint job on that. It's like a pearl white with a little bit of chartreuse underneath that bill. This thing dives to 2 to 4 feet. You know, small little jerk bait, double hooks, Kitana hooks. So, but they've got a little bit of bend back. I prefer those bend back hooks, just like the band it has on it. Again, it's a 3.2 inch bait. Good little jerk bait there. Next, we've got the Castic Swim Bait Boot Tail. That's this guy. Not a fan of how elementary it looks, but it will catch fish. They even leave you a little eyelet down here to add treble hooks if you want to add it from the belly side, if you want to get it hung up on stuff. But they've also got your single hook up here with your eyelet. Not really a fan of the paint job. I could do without all the little appendages here. Really just need the boot tail. That boot tail is what's going to give us a ton of action. And I can't really tell how soft it is to see how well that boot tail's, how much action that boot tail is going to have on it, but it's okay. Next, we have the Carl's Amazing Baits Shiver Crank. Okay, so this one I really like. This is a 6 to 10 foot diving shiver crank. It's probably going to have a real tight wobble with the name Shiver. It kind of has that similar to a shad wrap look to it. I mean, it's not like Ketchco would copy a bait or anything, so it's probably not like that at all. Anyway, so it's got the little shad pattern, blue back, little bit of like, it's silver, but it's also gold. It's really nice, a little hologram in there. And yeah, I mean, that's pretty much this bait. I really like this bait. Out of all the baits in here so far, this has got to be number one. Up next is the Z-Man TRD Hogs. That's gonna be these guys. You know how much I love the Z-Man Elastec. A lot of folks don't realize this, but this Elastec is not like your normal soft plastic. You really need to store it in this bag. Do not put it with other soft plastics, your regular Plastisol-based soft plastics. They'll actually melt almost immediately. A lot of people think these have a very low melting temperature. Not true, it's just that they can't be with other soft plastics. So keep them in the bag. Just a little tip here. This thing would go really good on a Ned rig, but there's actually another bait in here that I think it would match pretty well with. As well as you know, is these are pretty buoyant. So those appendages are gonna stick up and go crazy in the water. So Ned Rig, but I've also got something in here. I'm spying that I think these would go really good on. Actually, the thing I think it'd go really well on is next. It's the Mullix Nano Jig. This guy, I think these paired together would actually be pretty good. You see where the point on this, the eye on this jig is. If you fish it slow enough, it'll actually somewhat stand up, almost like a Ned Rig, but you can also drag it, swim it, do whatever you want, but it is a net or a finesse, a very small finesse style jig. Throw this on there and I think you've got a pairing that's, you know, match made in heaven. Up next, we got penetration hooks. These guys, and it actually tells you right here, 6-inch lizard, 5-inch fluke, 5-inch Senko, 8-inch jelly worm. So it gives you what size hook it is. It's a 3-aught hook. There's three in here. Let's talk, I'm gonna open this up real quick just to show you something I think is pretty cool on this, but also is a little confusing. Running my soft plastic worms pretty high on the hook, like right near the eye. Look at the bait keeper on that thing. The bait keeper is right on the eye, so you'd have to bring the bait up a little bit past it for that bait keeper. I like the idea. I think it's a little too high. I don't want to cover up the line that much, but hey, to each his own, but I think that's pretty cool. And last but not least, the Excites Baits Undershad. Let's pull these out. The cool thing about these are not a boot tail. It's not a jerk flute where it's got the little fork tail. This actually has a curly tail on it. And I'm a big fan of curly tails. It gives it just a little bit more action. Maybe not as much of a thud in the water as a boot tail would, but this is definitely gonna move a little bit of water, give them something that they haven't really seen too much of in a fluke style bait. So that is this box in a nutshell. We're gonna jump over to Chris real quick, let him unbox his Monster Bass box, and then we're gonna let you guys decide. We'll give you our opinions on which box we think is the best box this month. So let me get this back in the box. We'll jump over to Chris.
All right, guys, let's check out the Monster Bass box. Uh-oh, we have a problem.
We do have a problem.
And as you can see, we got the Regional Pro Series box.
So time out real quick. I was actually contacted by Monster Bass Box literally last video we did of these unboxings, and they said they wanted to upgrade me to the regional box. This is Chris's box, but it's in my name. And we went through the process of them talking to me about it, and then they just went like radio silent. They didn't get back with me on upgrading, giving a promo code to upgrade, but it appears they upgraded me anyway. So this is probably gonna be a little bit unfair, but we're gonna still go along with this anyway.
So let's see what we got in the box. It looks like everything's from the 2019 iCast or a new color by a company for 2020. So we got the Booyah iCast bait, which is this, which is the Prank. Looks like it's a cream color with red, and it's got a feather tail of white and red. Well, it looks like a red and green sparkle. It's called the Booyah Prank Bone Shiner. It's a 3-inch topwater bait.
So what makes this different is the size. The Booyah Prank original was a little bit smaller. That one's a little bit bigger.
Next, another bait for 2019 was a freshwater lure winner, the Lunker Phantom Spider. I don't really know about this. I can't see myself fishing with a spider.
The legs fall off very easily. So you're probably gonna lose some legs as you try to fish with that. Just throwing that out there. But it's just your normal topwater bait.
Doesn't tell you what size.
You want me to tell you what size it is?
Sure.
Large. If I saw a spider that size in my house.
Look, water spiders are about that big.
Yeah, we're moving. That's what.
Arbogast, if I can find it now. There we go. Looks like we got a Hula Papa by Arbogast. It's a Hula Papa number 2 in a red and black pattern. It's got feathers for the tail. Hula Papa. It looks like they're going for spring here instead of winter.
So basically we've got 3 topwater baits so far.
All right, next for iCast is the VM, a pork shad. Looks like a fluke. It's used by Cliff Pace. Apparently he designed this. Let's see what it looks like. All right, so it's a little fluke with a little split tail, tiny split tail. Color on this thing is a multitude of colors. It's a green pumpkin purple haze. You can see it's got the pumpkin here and a little purple right here in the belly going through. Smells good though. Smells like it's got anise in it, which is licorice. Next up is the Rattle Trap. So this is a Bill Lewis original Rattle Trap. Now this looks like it's the orange spot. It's got the mustad hooks, and it's the weight is a 1/2 ounce and a length of 3 inches. I like that. Nice looking little rattle trap there. Almost reminds me of a shell cracker. Next up is Rabid Baits. I never heard of these people. Let's see what they got. Here we go. Oh wow, look at that. So we got a worm. It's called the shaker worm, and it's got fur for the tail, on the tip of the tail.
Yeah, it's like some little feathers there on the tail.
So they call this the green orange, the green pumpkin orange, Charlie Brown. It's got, looks like this orange with more orange and black flake. Pretty interesting with that. Like to see how that looks in the water, how that would float. Designed for a shaky head. We have the X Zone Pro Series. So this is called the Monster Hot Ned Rig Bait. So let's see what this looks like. So it looks like it's a split color. You got like a green pumpkin with the orange flake, sort of like this one. And then on the bottom is a white with some blacking. I'd say that chartreuse flake. So it's set up for a Ned Rig. It's got a little bulbous on the end. Give it a little extra motion. I think the ladies will like that, because it looks like a male part. Last but not least, Dache Hooks, Premium Fishing Hooks. They're 2-aught size. Oh, Jimmy Houston on there. It said it's an offset wide gap worm hook, but I mean, I wouldn't call that wide gap. But that's the size hook I use on just about all my Texas rigs, so that would be good. Well, that's it. All right, we got a couple stickers. We got the Budweiser Monster Bass sticker and the Rabid Bait sticker.
Sweet. All right, we're gonna flip y'all back around, do our little outro here, and then we'll tell you about the little secret surprise we got. All right, so I want you to get in the comments right now. Let me know which one you thought was the best box, and I have a feeling I know which one it's gonna be, because it was a little bit of an unfair advantage this month. We went with a $35 all iCast award-winning bait and against your standard MTB Pro box. I actually do like the stuff in my MTB Pro box. I think it's a box that I would use more stuff out of. Some of these in the Monster Bass box are too out there for me.
Just because, like, it's new, don't make it better.
The spider, I know that kind of took everybody by storm. Everybody was making spider topwater videos, but they didn't last. And you saw that in a lot of the videos, that the legs are just so flimsy, they just end up falling off after a couple fish hit them. And plus, a topwater bait is a topwater bait. They really only see the silhouette and they sort of go after it. I don't think bass actively run after spiders. I think it's a meal, but it's not the meal. It's basically just a reaction. You could probably go with, I would love to just melt down like a piece of plastic, like in a pickle shape, and just see if we could catch fish on it. You know, I think that's possible, because it's just a reaction to them. Something splashing at the top of the water that they want to eat. What do you think about the boxes?
Agree. I mean, yeah, it's got a bunch of new stuff in there. Don't fish a lot of top water, especially spiders, hula poppers. Outside the rattle trap and the soft plastics, about equally the same, I think.
What do you think of the soft plastic with a feather in it?
Now that is interesting. I'd like to see how that works.
I think it would catch fish just because it's so different.
It's going to give you that more extra little fine movement as that bait's moving, as you're moving. It's just going to like a crappie jig has that fine thing. So.
See, and I think out of the crankbaits, I know that rattle trap is a staple and it's going to catch fish. But I really like the shiver in here, and I like the that little jerk bait too. I think the hard plastics in here were really, really good. But let us know in the comments what you think your favorite is. And do you have something you want to tell the people about what, I mean, it's your box. You can do what you want with it, but.
So ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen and ladies, if you want this box, you know what you gotta do.
You gotta like the video, leave that comment below what your favorite bait was, what your favorite box was this month. And as always, hit the red subscribe button, turn it gray, hit the ding dong notification so you'll be notified anytime we release a new video, and you'll be entered to win. Just do those three things and you're golden. If you want to follow us on Instagram, I'm putting the Instagram handles below. Do that. Make sure you join the BFF, the Bee Fishing family. Hope you enjoyed this unboxing, and we'll catch you on the next one. Later, guys.